John Harrison's 900-acre Wildwood Farm in South Central Virginia has been in his family for more than a century. With an eye to the future, John has cut back on his beef cattle herd and now has trees on former pasture land. The trees help control erosion and nutrient runoff, which means cleaner water flowing from the farm to the Chesapeake Bay.
When we get a 1-inch rain, the stream that our streams run into would be muddy. Ours is always clear. It never gets muddy.
Thousands of trees have been planted, with the costs covered by a local company that is using this positive practice for the environment to offset negative water quality effects within the same river basin.
It is a land conversion project where we took active subprime farmland and placed a timber product on it.
The timber product, riparian buffers and forested areas, qualifies under state law as a bank of tradable nutrient credits. Over time, the credits are traded for cash from developers, who are required to address water quality when they build roads, parking lots, and such in Virginia. The cash covers the cost of the tree planting project and payments to the farmer.
What you've seen today on this farm with this nutrient bank, I think, is probably the most innovative new cash revenue stream that we have for paying for bay cleanup. And it was done with private money.
The USDA's Natural Resources Conservation Service works with farmers and ranchers to help them protect the environment and keep their operations sustainable, both of which are happening here.
This farm is really a watershed success story and a great example of how a nutrient bank can work.
It's a first step in cleaning up the rivers in the Chesapeake Bay, and it creates another revenue stream for us as well.
In Appomattox County, Virginia, for the U.S. Department of Agriculture, I'm Pat O'Leary.